At Abiding Presence, we are now celebrating Eucharist in extraordinary times. Eucharist is another word for Holy Communion. It is the way that we will celebrate the sacrament of Holy Communion virtually in this season when we can no longer be together face to face in the sanctuary around the altar. We know that right now that we are called to be church for the sake of the world by staying home. We are not going to push to quickly reopen our worship space because we know that God is present wherever we gather, even when we gather together virtually. And the prayers that we pray, the songs that we sing, the scripture that we share together in worship is just as much worship when we do so virtually as when we do so face to face. And as we enter into this season of sharing Holy Communion, when we can't be physically present with one another, there's a scripture passage that has been guiding me, that's been on my heart, and I want to share that with you. It comes from Matthew's Gospel, the 14th chapter. It's the story of Jesus' feeding of the 5,000. Hear the beginning of the story. Now, when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages to buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." And many of you may recall what happens next. The disciples tell Jesus that all they have is a meager offering, a few loaves and a few fish, and it won't possibly feed all the people. And Jesus makes it work. He makes those few loaves and those few fish enough not just to feed the crowds who were gathered that day, but to feed them with leftovers to spare. And in this season, when we haven't been able to gather together face to face, I've heard from many of you about your hunger to receive Holy Communion, about your longing to once again be able to share in the body and blood of Christ. We know that when we share in communion, that we experience a foretaste of the feast to come. We are united with the great cloud of witnesses who have gone before us, and we taste and see God's love and forgiveness for us in a powerful way. And in this season, we want to now be able to share that together. And much like happened that day long ago when Jesus took the few loaves and fish and made it enough, we trust that Jesus, through the Holy Spirit, will come and make our offerings enough too. That the bread or crackers that we share, that the wine or grape juice or water that we pour will be made Christ's body and blood, the real presence of Jesus for us wherever we gather. When we do so in the course of worship, Pastor Joe or I will stand behind the altar and we will pray the words of institution, the same prayer that we usually do. And we will trust that the Holy Spirit will find the way to come from where we are into your homes, and that we will be united into the body of Christ for the sake of the world, that we will be joined together in this time when we can't be physically present with one another, and we will share in the meal of Holy Communion. Jesus' words keep ringing in my head. You give them something to eat. And we trust that as we do, that God will be the one to provide, that God will be the one to show up through the Holy Spirit, so that we can share in the body and blood of Christ together.